Today, let's continue on Quantum Christian with Powerful Living and Behaving as Pursuing the Upward Calling. That's recorded in Philippians chapter 3 and verse 14.
I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus.
Paul gives himself as an example regarding how to behave during the everyday living of our lives while we wait for Christ to gather all of us together with him. Paul writes, "I pursue," and that's in the good sense of following or proceeding earnestly after, in accordance with, the target or the object that is to be scoped, watched, looked at intensely by me, so as to determine my own actions carefully. So Paul is saying, I pursue according to the target into the prize with a view to and resulting in the garland. That's what the prize is, a garland, which is only awarded to the victor or the winner of a race, of the upward calling of God. This prize pertains to God's upward invitation, the calling which is above, over, in an upward direction. And figuratively, that refers to the fact that this calling is heavenly. It comes or proceeds from God. And some texts include the words in Christ Jesus. God has issued his invitation to all of mankind by means of the Lord Jesus Christ. And all holy people, Christians, accepted it at the moment that we believed what God says regarding himself and his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And thus, we receive the gift of Holy Spirit. At a future time, we will receive all that God has promised to us in Christ Jesus our Lord. We will receive the prize to be awarded to every holy person, every Christian who is running in the race at the present time. And Paul uses athletic terminology, which draws attention to holy people or Christians, and the truth that we are all together moving in the same direction, the same objective, being on the same team in the same contest. Let's look at the washing of regenesis and newing up of Holy Spirit. And this is in Titus chapter 3, verses 4 to 7.
But after that, the kindness and the love of God our Savior toward man appeared, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy he saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost, which he shed on us abundantly through Jesus Christ our Savior, that being justified by his grace, we should be made heirs according to the hope of eternal life.
When the malevolence or kindness, that is supplying what is appropriately needed for use in specific situations, and the love for men, that brotherly or friendly kind of love towards mankind, human beings, that emanates from God our Savior. The only true God is the source of salvation for all holy people, all Christians. So when the benevolence and the love for men emanating from God our Savior was brought to light upon us, God's benevolence and his love for us as one unit was caused to have its light shone upon us. And so it was made evident to us, visible, shining this light forth upon us. And this did not originate from works in righteousness or the deeds within the sphere of action, character, and attributes of justice that we did, you know, that we performed as though we were the ones who did everything righteously. The truth being that we were not righteous at the time. And so we definitely could not do any works in righteousness, but it was according to his mercy, God's act of relief withholding merited judgment. He did not bestow punishment on us who deserve to be punished. So when the benevolence and the love for men emanating from God our Savior was brought to light upon us, not originating from works in righteousness, what we did, but it was according to his mercy, He, God, saved us by means of, he made us safe through the washing of regenesis or regeneration. It's the washing that pertains to regeneration. It has the character and quality of Genesis again, the second Genesis, the second origin or source, as opposed to the first Genesis. The washing that consists of the second genealogy of lineage, race, kind, descent of mankind or human beings, and the newing up of Holy Spirit. It's that newness, that which was made new in an upward motion that pertains to Holy Spirit. It has the character and quality of sanctified spirit. That's what holy means, sanctified. We're saints. That sanctified spirit, it consists of Holy Spirit, which is the Spirit of Christ. It is newly made and different from what was previously in effect. New because it replaces the old, new compared to what was there previously for and with mankind, human beings, which Holy Spirit God poured out on us wealthily. He shed forth Holy Spirit down on us richly by means of Jesus Christ, our Savior. It was through Jesus Christ who is our Savior, because Jesus Christ is the one who accomplished what was needed to be done by mankind so as to save mankind, to be made safe for the purpose and result that after we were made righteous, justified with or by the grace of that one, the freely bestowed unmerited favor belonging to and emanating from that one, what one? Jesus Christ, our Savior, we may be caused to become inheritors. We would come to pass to be heirs, people who have the inheritance, the assigned lot, the allotted portion, according to the hope of eternal life, the expectation that God has given to us of a future event occurring, which is eternal life, lifelong life, everlasting life, life that lasts throughout all durations of life, all ages,